Hi, my name is Jason Lilly with the University of Maine Cooperative Extension, and in this video we're going to be talking about the 10 principles of tractor safety. So these 10 principles are important ones to keep in mind whenever working on or around tractors and farm equipment to ensure that everyone is staying safe. The first principle is to know the tractor, its implements, and how they work. And there's a few different ways to go about this. The first is to look at the operator's manual for the tractor or the implement that you'll be using. So the operator's manuals have key information about how often you should be doing maintenance, where the various parts of the tractor are, and how the tractors operate. Another way to go about it is to find someone who's familiar with that piece of equipment. So that may be the farm owner where you're working, or a neighbor farmer who has more experience with the various pieces of equipment and who knows the ins and outs of the different pieces of equipment. The second principle is to always make sure that if your tractor is installed with a ROPS or a rollover protective structure, that you have that in the upright position, and that if that ROPS is on the tractor, you always have your seat belt on. So what the ROPS is designed to do is if the tractor were to roll over, you'd be protected in your seat between the top of the rollover bar and the front of the tractor. So in rollover accidents where the ROPS is installed but people do not have their seat belt on, there's about a 75% safety rating on that, where 75% of the time people avoid injury and possible death. With your seatbelt on, that number goes up to 97%. So really important to have your rollover protective structure up and to always have your seatbelt on when you're driving. If you're on an older tractor that was built before rollover bars were mandated, then there are programs out there like the rollover protective structure rebate program, where you can get money back to retrofit those rollover bars on your old tractor. So the third principle is to be familiar with the terrain and the surroundings of where you're working. So this is particularly important if you're working in tall grass, so if you're bush hogging or haying, and what you wanna do is make sure that you're walking through the fields, you're looking for any stumps or groundhog holes or ditches, and making sure that you're not going to run into anything that could cause the tractor to become unstable and potentially roll over, or to get into anything that could just damage the tractor. The fourth principle is about carbon monoxide awareness. So whenever you're starting a tractor to warm it up, which is particularly important in the winter time, you want to start that tractor and roll it outside of a barn or an enclosed structure to make sure that those exhaust fumes are leaving the area. So this is really important because of the potential for carbon monoxide poisoning for people who are working in that barn and also for livestock. Next, we have to make sure that your PTO shaft or your power takeoff shaft is properly shielded at all times. So these shafts transport an enormous amount of power from the tractor to the implement, and they spin at 540 rotations per minute, or 9 times per second. And no human force is going to stop that from spinning. So it's really important that you make sure that these shields are working properly, that they aren't broken, and that they are in place to make sure that you don't get any, you know, shoestrings, clothing, hair, anything like that stuck in around the shaft. Also, it's really important to not be around these shafts or the back of the tractor when the tractor is running. So the sixth principle is to always keep your hitches low and on the drawbar. So the drawbar is designed so that when you're towing things and pulling things behind the tractor, if that thing that you're towing were to get caught up and stuck on a stump or get a flat tire, that the drawbar would actually pull the front end of the tractor closer to the ground and make sure that you remain stable. What some people will do is hitch up to the rollover bars or the, you know, the protective structure on the cab, thinking that it will get, you know, the butt end of a log or something like that up out of the ground. But if that thing that you're pulling were to get stuck, this would actually pull the whole tractor over backwards and cause a rollover. So it's very important to only ever attach and hitch trailers onto your drawbar. So the next principle is to never get off of a moving or a running tractor. So most tractors, particularly old tractors, will continue to move forward until someone takes them out of gear. And that doesn't matter if someone's on the tractor or off of the tractor. So if someone were off the tractor, it was in gear, it would run forward until it ran into someone or something. And that's definitely a situation we want to avoid. We also want to make sure that the tractor is always off before you get off of the tractor. And that's because there's several cases where people accidentally put the tractor into gear while getting off, and that has led to accidents and injuries. And there's also the chance that if you were working around the back side of the tractor, that someone could accidentally engage the PTO or other components of the tractor and cause entanglements or other injuries that way. So always want to make sure that the tractor is off and that the parking brake is securely set before getting off the tractor. Next, we want to make sure that the tractor is cooled down before checking any of the fluids or refueling. So if you were to open, say, the radiator to check the coolant while the tractor is very hot, there's a burn potential around that. And if you were to refuel when the tractor is very hot, and especially when it's running, there's the potential that the fumes from that fuel could ignite and cause a fire. The ninth principle is to never have any riders on the tractor and to be aware of children and animals and people around the tractor. So a tractor has one seat, which means that there should only ever be one person on that tractor. There's too high of a potential for people to fall off the tractor, to fall under wheels, under implements, and it's just not worth that risk. Before you get on the tractor, you should always do a walk around all the way around the tractor to make sure that there aren't any animals or kids or people playing under or around the tractor. And the 10th principle is to never be in a hurry. So farming is a job where there always feels like there's something else to do. There might be weather coming in. There's a lot that needs to be done in a short amount of time. But with that in mind, it's just extra important that while we're working under pressure, maybe tired, that we're taking those few extra seconds to do the tractor walk around, to review what we're hooking up, to review the jobs that we're doing, to make sure that they're being done in as safe of a manner as possible.